in this video, we're going to look at how we would treat the neck. There are many causes for neck pain, neck stiffness. One very common reason these days is that ubiquitous computer and the way you sit at your office desk, or worse still, sitting with a laptop on your knee on the sofa or the beach or somewhere like that. And this often causes all this area in the nape of the neck, the base of the neck, to stiffen up and become almost immovable. Another cause, of course, is whiplash. Now, if you've ever had an accident on a bicycle or a car or a motorbike and it's never been treated, you've almost certainly got residual whiplash, and it can affect your spine way down into that thoracic area. The first technique I'm going to use is to get into these vertebrae, between the gap, between the vertebra, the little gap, and I'm going to do STLCs, one of the most fundamental spine work techniques, slow, tiny, little circles. And it's this sort of movement, but very, very small. And without a lot of pressure, I'm not pushing in. I'm just doing, working with the tissue, just to go into the tissue and feel it opening. And I can almost feel it saying, ah, thank you, Ian. And then I move down to the next gap. And the same again. And because we're working just this area, I'm then going to come up into the gap above. So in here, right into this side of the vertebra. And this can take some while, because that neck may have been locked up for quite a long time. And as I do the circles, I can gently push it either side, very, very gently, just to see if there's a little bit of movement in between those vertebrae. The other technique I'm going to use is to release all this tissue around here. And I often work bilaterally, but they are usually not the same. So with my right thumb on Sarah's left, there's some really tight lump of tissue in there, and there may be a cellulome or trigger point by any other name in there, and I would just hold it. Otherwise, I'm just gently asking that tissue to release. On the other side, we've got a little response there, so I'm just going to hold that tissue there. And as I wait, that tissue just breathes deeply and starts to relax and open. Now, don't rush this part of the technique if you're doing a neck technique, because it can take a long time for this tissue to release. It may have been locked up like that for many months or many, many years even. The next phase of working the neck, I will ask Sarah to turn over. So we're going to take a break from this video, and I'm going to ask you to come back in a minute or two and look at part two. Thanks for watching.